Be it unto you all and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him doth this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which is become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. To me, that is saying that there's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody that can save you like Jesus. There's nobody who can keep you from being saved but you. If you go to the Lord, if you believe on him, his grace will save you. There are not enough hypocrites that can keep you from being saved. You know the hypocrites I am talking about. Those Bible-knowing, tongue-talking, church seat-occupying Pharisee-like Christians who want to keep you away from church. They judge you because they are in judgment. They condemn you because they are condemned. The hypocrite is far from God, but always wants you to believe they are closer to God than you are. Nobody should keep you away from Jesus. We live in a day where instead of giving God the glory and honor and thanking him for our very being, we find ourselves complimenting and bragging each other, bragging on ourselves. The church has even taken secondary issues and given them priority to the neglect of the essentials. We are majoring in minors and minoring in majors. The things that matter most, we give little attention, and the things that don't matter, we go all out for them. The church today is so pragmatic, it is so programmed and structured, it is so success conscious and so success centered, until we are striving for fulfillment of our own needs. We are trying to satisfy our own desires. The church has stepped into a philosophy of religious humanism. We have turned away from God and turned to human beings. We see our streets littered with billboards with pictures of both big and small men of God, marketing fancy and seductive themes and messages, more of man and less of God. Many of us are like that today. The least I can do is give him glory. The least I can do is give him thanks. I have been saved, and I was saved by grace through faith. And the faith was a gift of God. What have I then to brag about? I have got nobody to brag about but Jesus himself. We have turned away from him. Many people are more loyal to their friends around them than they are to the Lord Jesus. You see, if I borrow money from you, I'll pay you. But when it comes to giving God what I owe him or what he has asked me to do, then I start to waffle. We are more loyal to sports than we are to the Lord. Man U, Chelsea, Real Madrid and Barcelona have more allegiance from us. When they start winning, we lose our minds and dance all over the room. But when I come to worship God, I get all dignified and status conscious. I wonder what the people are going to say about me. I don't want to ruin my reputation. Where are the sports teams now? Isn't it strange that people look everywhere for salvation and turn away from the only one who can save us? There's no substitute for salvation. There's no substitute for the Word of God. There's nobody like Jesus. I don't care what you want to try, you will find out soon enough that only Jesus can save. People are looking for substitute saviors, and people are looking for pseudo gods. That's the reason why so many are on drugs. They are looking for a way out. Well, I tell you, the only way out is Jesus. He's the only one who can bring us out. There's no need to depend on drugs. We have a drug for everything. If you are sleepy, there's a drug to wake you up. If you have insomnia, there's a drug to make you sleep. If you are fat, there's a drug to make you lean. And if you are lean, there's a drug to make you fat. If you have a busy day, you take a pep pill. You come back in the evening, you calm down with some wine or brandy. Listen, all you need is Jesus. I am so glad that he has provided a communication system where I can get in touch with him anywhere, talk to him about anything, and nobody is in my way and nobody can cut off the system. We're in mysterious, difficult, scary, and interesting times. The coronavirus is redefining our world at an alarming pace. Over 300,000 people dead across the world, and some of us still think it is a gimmick. Some ask that the NCDC should prove that this is real by showing us the people in isolation centers. Others want to see the bodies of the dead, while others see this as a money-making scheme. With each passing day, we get more confused. Lockdown or not lockdown, vaccines or no vaccines, open the economy and let people die from the virus, or close the economy and let people die from hunger. Questions, questions, and more questions without an answer in sight. It is a bit too much. Some have stopped listening to the news to preserve their sanity, while others pursue all sorts of conspiracy theories. Churches are shut and can no longer provide the four walls of weekly or bi-weekly refuge. Millions have lost their jobs and millions are starving. Government has failed, science has failed, and man has failed. But I come to tell you that Jesus never fails. He is alive and sits on his mercy throne. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock, and now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Who are you waiting on, Real Madrid? Who are you waiting on, government? Who are you waiting on, pastor? Who are you waiting on, daddy? Who are you waiting on, your boss? Who are you waiting on, native doctor? Who are you waiting on, husband? Who are you waiting on, the big man? Wait on the Lord. He never fails. God bless you all.